Welcome back. It is just after 8:30. Let's go back to that breaking news coming out of Sydney now, where climate protesters are right now marching through our city's CBD. We've got our reporter Gabrielle Boyle right there on the scene for us. Gabby, talk us through what you're seeing and hearing.
Laura, you'll have to forgive me. I'm a little bit out of breath, to be honest, because we have just marched at a very quick pace right through the city with these protesters. They are absolutely making their way through the street as quickly as possible, and they're being tailed by dozens of police. They're angry, they're cranky, they want their voices heard. You can hear those drums there. Several of them have been arrested already. They've shut down many major streets. We're just passing Martin Place at the moment, and you can see that both directions the traffic has stopped. This is one of the busiest streets.
It seems like our signal there to Gabby might be a little bit patchy. We'll actually let her catch her breath for a couple of seconds. But as you can see, these are live pictures coming from Sydney's CBD right now, where those climate activists are marching through the city. We've been seeing some shots come through already. It looks like the protesters have been trying to use everything from wheelie bins to plastic crates to even some plastic bollards in the city. You can see some of those pictures there from social media to block the roads. Police have been hot on their heels, though. They have been quickly, as soon as those protesters have been trying to block those roads, police have been very quickly there to clean up that scene. But as you can see from Gabby, they did start initially at Hyde Park this morning, and within the last half hour, they have moved very, very quickly. This is the heart of Sydney CBD, right in the middle of the business district there. Lots of people, as you'd imagine, at this time of the morning, 8:30, need to make the commute, whether through public transport or via car. I think we've re-established our connection now to Gabby. What's the mood and the sense from the police and the protesters this morning? Is it so far seeming relatively calm, or is it starting to amp up?
Laura, these protesters are very cranky, but I can tell you also is quite cranky is the police. They're being forced to follow these protesters. They're throwing down milk crates, they're throwing down roadwork material. I've even seen in one circumstance them throwing down slabs of concrete, narrowly missing police officers' feet. I tell you what, these police have their job cut out for them. It is dangerous work. These protesters are making their way towards the harbour, towards the Opera House, down onto the shores of Sydney Harbour there. We initially thought they may have been heading for the Harbour Bridge. Doesn't look to be the case, but it is more in the direction of the Opera House now. But this is bringing major traffic delays and problems in Sydney for police. We've had the chopper above, we've had the police horses out as well, and certainly plenty of police motorbikes and cars. You've been able to hear those sirens right throughout the morning. What's interesting, as I said before, is that these protesters really don't have much to say when the media approach them. I ask many of them to talk to me. They simply won't say anything, but they do want to be heard and they do want to protest on one of the busiest streets in Sydney at the busiest time of day, Laura.
This protest is going to have huge knock-on effects this morning right throughout Sydney CBD. Gabrielle Boyle, thank you very much.
Chaos is the word here, isn't it? Chaos. And this has been happening for months now. We had people at Port Botany hanging off bridges. We had people gluing themselves to roads up around Sydney's northern beaches. That is the traffic right now heading into the Sydney CBD. It is bumper to bumper and it's not moving anywhere. There's one guy now backing up. I don't know how he's going to do that.
That's actually southbound. So that's from the north side of the bridge there. So a car has come in and it's the driver's got out, blocked all the traffic, and you can only assume that at 10 minutes to 9 on a Monday morning, the amount of dramas that that is going to cause, just with traffic backing up, and even with police arriving there on the scene straight away. I mean, I just don't reckon these guys help their cause at all.
No, they don't.
No one is sitting here and, you know, and you know, the cause and to fight for the climate, you know, good on you, and but to do this and to be so disruptive, it in no way helps what they do. And it's a big job there for this morning. It's a waste of police resources.
And Gabby said to us this morning, she actually stopped one of the protesters and asked them what they were protesting about. They wouldn't even say. They wouldn't even tell us. So there's a media ban from these idiots, obviously. I mean, we can all guess what they are protesting, which is climate change. But this is just not the way to go about it. And as we said, that traffic is not moving.
You can't imagine if you're a nurse or a teacher, you're trying to make your commute to work this morning, that you would have much sympathy for the chaos that these protesters are causing throughout our CBD.
And we already have strikes coming up. We've got teachers striking on Thursday, we've got nurses striking as well, and then we have these people. So it's just never ending, it seems.
All right, let's get straight to our top story this morning. It is breaking news in Sydney where climate protesters are causing chaos on the morning commute. We're hearing the southbound lanes of the Harbour Tunnel are still closed after a woman chained herself inside her car at the Harbour Tunnel entrance. Let's go to Today reporter Gabrielle Boyle, who's in the CBD. Gabby, what's happening where you are now?
Well, certainly, Ali, things escalated very quickly and they've calmed down very quickly. As you can see, we've still got police here on the streets making sure everything's under control. But those protesters have dispersed. They've headed in every which direction from the centre of the city here. One of those protesters has joined me this morning, though. Genevieve, what brought you out to protest today?
The main thing that's brought me out is that I'm so distressed about the state of climate. I have been in protests in my 20s. I have never ever engaged in civil disobedience, but I feel the situation has become so obviously desperate.
Do you understand that many members of the public are really cranky at you for stopping traffic and making getting to work really difficult?
Yes, I can understand that totally, and I have been very resistant to be a part of this, but I feel like it's gotten so urgent that we really do need to make such a full-on stand that it makes it to the media and it makes it to the news. I also really want to say that I have a son here who's 25, who is with a beautiful partner, and they have both decided they cannot have children because this is not a world to bring their children into. And that
Thank
is
you for
really
your perspective this morning. Must interrupt you there. Thank you very much. No, Ali, there were other issues I wanted to bring our viewers up to date with, one of them being that in the Harbour Tunnel southbound, we had, as you said, a woman chaining herself to her steering wheel and then live streaming the incident on Facebook. You can only imagine the traffic chaos that that caused this morning in peak hour traffic. Sydney traffic on a Monday morning is bad at the best of times, but this really has made it so much worse. And those protesters walking through the streets in a really unscripted manner, throwing milk crates, throwing concrete slabs in some situations, building material, really being incredibly disruptive, picking up those sandwich boards and tables out the front of the cafes along these main strips and throwing them onto roadways here in the CBD. And of course, it's left to these guys and girls in blue to pick up that mess afterwards. I tell you what, they have earned their keep today. They've done an incredible job making sure the public who are just trying to get to work remain safe.
Yeah, and as you're speaking, Gabby, we're just looking at that vision of that woman who chained herself to a car at the entrance to the tunnel. She's chained herself around her neck to the steering wheel. And so police, we believe, had to cut her out because obviously she didn't have the key with her. We just heard the New South Wales Premier, Dominic Perrottet, on 2GB2 talking to Ben Fordham. He has called the protesters bloody idiots, and he says they will feel the full force of the law. So not taking anything there this morning. And that is the traffic backed up there. Southbound traffic we're looking at now. Look, cops were on it pretty quickly, but that is going to take a long time to clear when you consider it is peak hour on a Monday morning in Sydney. We know that there are issues with train drivers at the moment, so a lot of people have probably opted to drive to work today rather than catch public transport, which is just adding to all the dramas, and they're going to feel that backlog, you know, every point coming into the city, I imagine, for the next few hours. Thanks, Gabby.